I'm Director Ruth Kebati of New Life Adventurer Club. I'm leading a team of around 160 children, aged 4 years to 9 years, and a group of their parents. So in short, we are co-parenting in raising these children of the age of 4 years to 9 years for Jesus Christ. We have trainings which goes on in our calendar for the year. So every year we carry out an activity we call community service. We reach out to the community near us. So this year, 2021, we identified a community around us, which is a Saikeri community. So we assess the needs of the community, basically where our Saikeri Sabbath School is located. And we realized the church had realized the need of starting an academy school. So we, as adventurers and adventurer family fraternity, we assessed the needs and we found out that we have children who are now in grade one who needed so many items for their ongoing and their daily activities. So we identified needs like food, clothing. We also had needs for books. So we came together as a family, adventurer family, as a club. We wrote down and we decided to give contributions towards the same. So the adventurers' children donated their clothes, their shoes, and other basic items like storybooks they have read in grade one. So they gave, and parents contributed money, which we used to buy foodstuff, dry foodstuff, which the children will continuously use. So we were able to buy sacks of maize, beans, rice. We also bought sugar, which could be used in the as one of the ingredients in their porridge. So at least they can not go hungry as they are learning. And again, we also bought some books, which they are going to, the teachers are going to use in delivering the curriculum. As we know in Kenya now, basic education is very essential for every child. So no child will go not being attended. So we had that need, it touched us. So we bought some textbooks for grade one, which are going to be used by these children. We are very happy to learn that there are 27 children who are not really located in any school in this community. So we decided together with the church to join hands so that we can give them the basic education. So I want to thank so much the parents, the well-wishers who joined us hands as a club to raise funds, to give their belongings, to give their items. And even today, we are very happy that we have joined in a lunch. We have shared a meal with these children and this community in our Sabbath school after service. And we are really happy. They are very happy. And we are really sending our thank you so much for those who gave their all so that they can touch our heart for Jesus Christ. Secondly, we want to appeal. There are so many needs, including the, if somebody out there is listening to me, who happens to come from the leadership of this Maasai community, especially Saikeri, they need to join hands with this community to provide the basic need, which is water. This community has no water completely. They really get water from Ngong, which is several kilometers away. So we appeal to the leadership of this community, both in the political and the church, that they may join hands to come and at least drill a borehole which can serve this community so that we can touch so many lives of children who are not getting even the basic community, which is water.
My name is Kevorina, a parent at New Life Church, and a member of council for the Adventurers Club. Opportunity to first thank God for this opportunity that they've allowed us to come and spend this community service on this Sabbath with the Saikeri congregation. We do not take it lightly. The weather has been hot, very, very like to thank the director together with the team, and also the Pathfinder director together with her team for making this a successful day. We've had a nice time, wonderful time, having this celebration of Sabbath in the St. Mary's Church. I think what I would also like to say is that we have seen that this church has brought together the people who live around here, the families. The children actually benefit from this school, though as small as it is. But we're beginning to see an impact. Even the songs that they were singing, you would see, they would sing it in English, they would sing it in Swahili. So for sure, this school is giving an impact to the community around here. And one of their greatest needs right now is water. Is that this place they have to walk for kilometers for them to get water. We had actually to carry our own water so that we could drink and wash our hands and be able to hold this function here. So one of the greatest needs of this church and school right now is definitely water. And if we as a church can come together, hold our hands, raise some funds and put up a book, then this will also be able to bring even more people to the church. It will be like a magnet that will attract people to the church, and with that we'll be able to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ to the community around. Just like in the desert when Moses raised his rod, and anybody who looked at the rod will be cured from any snakebite. So if we lift this church, then we also expect the community around to look at this church, to look at that well of water where it doesn't dry, and be able to see semblance of Jesus in it. And definitely as a church we'll be able to make an impact on this community. I think yes, we need a God and may God continue to guide us and to give us the grace to continue to serve God in this mission. Thank you very much.